Nikki, the road to the championships become a little less crowded, but there still isn't enough room for both of these teams. Which team will become a casualty of the second round in this game between the Delaware Fighting Blue Hens and the Colorado State Rams?
This place is rocking and rolling, baby!
The Rams should be able to run away with this one, Dick Vitale.
Hey, what are the keys for them doing so? The keys are pretty simple, Brad. First, the point guard has to be the leader out there. He's got to be the coach on the floor. Second of all, pound the ball inside. Challenge their big men. Thirdly, take care of the basketball. Turnovers can really kill any rhythm offensively.
I think you're dead on, Mr. Vitale. Let's see what happens. Let's get this one started. The ball goes out of bounds. Dickie's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
He nails the bucket. Both teams looking to get things going here. Dumps it in. The center takes the feed. Pass down low. There's a drop step, and oh, good defense.
I thought defense reacted and beat him to the spot. Very poor job with the drop step. Very slow.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Dick, I think there's a mismatch in the post.
Let's see if they can get him the ball. Double team now, bad angle.
Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
Our three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline. Pump fakes.
Nice fake.
Jump hook from the low block. And he missed. Keeps the dribble as they regroup. On the outside. Foul charge. I've seen you out there with pom-poms, Mr. Vitale, but not looking that good.
I tell you what, don't look that good. I can't dance like that, baby.
The shooting guard gets the pass. Keeps the dribble as they set it up again. For the bucket, perfectly executed. On the dribble, gives it up. That one puts the personal in personal. Picks up the foul.
I tell you, poor play defensively. Look at the facial expression.
This is the team's first trip to the free throw line. Gets the first shot. Both free throws go. Look to get it to the inside. Tries for two.
Unbelievable. Look at that post position. He can't get a piece of that, baby.
Moving it around the perimeter. Number 15 is eager and excited to compete.
Hey, whether you win or lose, you shouldn't be afraid to show your emotions.
All right, let's check in. Third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, the leading team down here is very relaxed. I'm down by their bench, and the coaches are reminding them, despite the score, try and remain focused. Remember, it's the first half. Anything can happen, guys.
He makes it.
The crowd will be on cloud nine if they can put some points up on the board.
Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
And he'll kick it back outside. The small forward takes the pass. He takes the shot from the baseline. Off the rim and no good. The Rams are a stop away from hearing this crowd go senseless. He does the sweet fake shot.
Nice little jam right there. The one-hand jam and stuff. A little showtime, a little pizzazz. Get out the mustard.
The center with the ball. Goes up for two. And in and out. Jumps into the defender. Patience by the dribbler being shown as the offense is reset. The center gets the ball. He takes the shot off the baseline. Way off target. Looking for a good shot. Jumps in. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. Fronts in first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Number 30 fakes the shot. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
Shot clock is dead.
Trying to go inside.
For two. Can't get the shot to drop. Drops the bucket despite the harm. Showing great patience as he waits for the reset of the offense.
Dump it inside.
Trying to feed inside. He got the steal. The pressure got to the ball handler.
Awesome ball pressure. It was too much for him, and he lost possession.
At the half, the Rams are ahead by two. Well, it's been a close one so far, Dick Vitale. What's your take on the play of the half?
I picked this basket in the paint for the highlight of the first half. We saw lots of inside scoring in the first half, and I think it's going to be the key for both teams in the second half.
Let's get back down to the action where it looks like the two teams are all set to start the second half. Colorado State did a heck of a job shooting that ball in the first half.
I mean, no doubt about it. These boys are given too much time to shoot, if you ask me. They basically have time to wait and get a good shot. The defense was non-existent, Mr. Nessler.
Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I can hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
Thanks, Erin. Richardson pounded on his way up. Oh, and look at the crowd, and look at the reaction.
I think the home fans are going crazy. There's jubilation.
And we'll go to the free throw line. Makes the shot. Second shot, good. Lancaster handles the feed. He misses it. Both teams looking to get things going here. Tries to turn, and the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
Blocked.
They keep saying, get that stuff out of here.
Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
Now they're into it. That's got some people out of their seats.
What a response. What enthusiasm.
Richardson in the paint for the bucket.
Great play to take that to the basket.
Looks at a three. He gets it to fall.
lot of pressure on him. Basketball. Way to play the ball. Tough. Drive him, beat him, turn him, beat him to his spot. Step out on that screener.
He makes a nice shot fake. The shot from the baseline. Off the rim and no good. He up fakes. Here's the offensive drop step and a low block, but better defense.
I tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline.
Gave it up. Number 30 has got the people in the bleachers up in appreciation.
The fans know exactly how much he has done for this program.
The offense gaining great post position down low.
Absolutely. Getting a good inside angle. Poor job defensively. No help. I mean, that is post play at its best. Brad, this crowd will be in a frenzy if they can get a basket on this possession.
They're working around the perimeter from right of the circle. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
Right now, it's a one-man show. The other players need to step up.
On the dribble, gives it up. Dickey still applying great pressure on the dribbler. Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, guys, after all, this is the NCAA Finals. In talking with both coaches before the game, they figured it would be a close game from start to finish. I'm certainly looking forward to the game's ending.
Thanks, Aaron. Controlling the ball. He strips in clean. They get it out into transition. Tries for two.
That was awesome, baby!
Well, Mr. Vitale, it looks like we're in for a great finish here.
Offensively, this is when it's extremely important to have the right people shooting the basketball at the right time.
Timeout. Let's check in with Aaron, who's standing by.
Brad and Dick, with limited time remaining, the coaches will have to figure out their offensive and defensive strategies for the next few possessions. What they will discuss or fail to discuss during this timeout could be the difference, guys.
Aaron's right about that. Let's get back out on the floor. 3 points is the difference.
That's right, so somebody better guard New York.
For the deuce. Can't get the shot to go. Dickey's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing them off.
And back they come the other way. Jump hook from the low block. I'm not sure that's who you want shooting the three.
I don't think the coach wants him taking that shot.
Mr. Vitale, how about that State Farm drive of the game?
Oh, Mr. Nestler, this one's superb. The ability to get close enough to the basket and then have the presence of mind to finish off the great play. Wow, what a play.
Working it around the perimeter. They're working around the arc.
Coming inside. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive. Even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. We'll get back to the action here after the timeout. Shot clock is dead. Kicks it out. The power forward receives the pass. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in. Then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Looking for a good shot. The power forward receives the ball. He lets it fly. Rims out. Dick, looks like we're staying for a while.
I'm not going anywhere. This is what it's all about, Mr. Nestler. Don't head for the exits yet. These teams are headed into overtime.
College basketball fans have gotten more than they even bargained for in this NCAA tournament because they get more for their buck overtime, Richard.
I'll tell you one thing, the excitement's unbelievable. The place is rocking and rolling. It's survive in advance, and you better make big plays right now. You better get momentum on your side in the OT.
On the outside, Lancaster handles the pass. He's got a nice shot fake for the bucket. Perfectly executed. Pressure's getting to him. Leans in. Basket falls despite the contact. Steal.
Nothing gonna come easy tonight, baby.
They are really playing for keeps. Dick, he really seems to be getting great position down there in the low block.
Yeah, he really is gaining possession because he gets the good angle, and they also have the good entry from the wing.
Looking for contact. Up and in.
Watch this again.
The drop step in the low block.
Oh, he does a great job using his footwork to get over the top of the defensive player.
Ouch! That's what I call a hard screen. This young man means so much to this team, and the fans just love him.
He means so much to the program. He's a consistent performer and always competes at a high level.
The fake. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Stolen. Here they come now on a turnover. For two. Contact causes the shot to come off. Gave it up. Tries for two.
Man, he ran his man right into the screen to get off that nice jumper.
Tremendous block. That's just great hustle and great defense with a steal.
I'll tell you what, they telegraphed that pass, and he read it perfectly defensively as a post player.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper on the outside. Look at that student body. They are going mad.
The student body looks like they're having some fun out there.
Look at him, Dick. He's trying to pump up the crowd. He and his team have made a series of great plays, and boy, do they have the momentum now.
And he's getting what he wants. This is what I love to see. The energy, the emotion, and passion, baby.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Questionable call there, Dick.
That's one of those calls that can go either way.
Well, Mr. Vitale, let's take a look at our backcourt production.
Hey, I'll tell you one thing, Brad. You look at the stats, you want to find out if your backcourt is playing well. Well, you want to ensure that your guards keep the number of turnovers down. That's a must. Reduce turnovers. So many games are won or lost by teams turning the ball over. Turnovers, missed opportunities happen, baby, when you turn the rock over.
Change things up a little bit, Dick.
We'll see what they come up with, Brad.
That brings the lead to 8 points, Dick.
But 8 points doesn't secure a win at this point, Brad.
Here's the three ball. Lancaster is getting it done for his team right now.
Hey, if it wasn't for his play, that'd be in big trouble, Brad. Someone else needs to step up.
There they come with a double team to stop it.
Up and inside.
Now they work it around the perimeter, looking for a good shot. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Timeout's called. Let's check in with Aaron Andrews.
Well, guys, this is a great opportunity for the coaches to calm their teams down. With this much time remaining, they're stressing play smart basketball and take care of the ball.
All right, Aaron, we're going to watch that the rest of the game.
Sometimes timeouts can take teams right out of their rhythm, Brad. Let's see what happens here.
It's a five-point ball game.
That's not a lot of points to be down with this much time, Brad.
Here he comes defensively on him on the low block.
I'll tell you, three-quarter position, trying to deny, but then he does a great job in post position and spreading his body and getting the ball.
Well, it's time to start fouling. They got to stop the clock, Nick. There's a look at the timeout situation.
Hey, some people like to call it game management, Brad. Knowing when to use timeouts is an art. Also, team fouls. Defending without fouling is always important.
The bonus situation. Makes the front end of the 1-1. They're seeing them all fall from the line tonight.
That's a crucial plus down the stretch, Brad.
Gets it. They're making good use of their free throw opportunities tonight.
Good free throw shooting teams seem to always give themselves a chance to win.
And all the way on the baseline, now the kick out. He takes the shot off the baseline. And they continue to foul to stop the clock.
Hey, now it's a matter of clock management, Brad. They have to foul in order to get back in this game.
How important is it to get to the free throw line?
Well, you know, those bonus points, Brad, you get those simple points. They add up at the end. Plus, you get people into foul trouble.
He misses his second shot. Shot clock is dead. He shoots from outside. That's an ill-advised shot.
Hey, a few more of those, he may wind up on a bench.
On the dribble, gives it up. Robs him of the ball. From three-point range. Good. Gave it up. Nick, sometimes statistics lie, but in this tournament game, I don't think they do. The better team won, and they're going on.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all the little intangibles we talked about, and that was the difference in the game.
The Rams graduates to the Sweet 16 now with two big wins in the first round.
Let me tell you, the coach has really lit a fire under the bellies of his players. Their opponents better come to play in the third round because these kids will be ready.
That's going to do it for us, folks. Thanks for being along. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler.